mag 8-8 na.
Yet fun to reminisce the many original Pinoy music that throughout the years have truly made everyone dance and sweat it out for fitness and exercise. Around 2010, Zumba was introduced to the Philippines as a form of workout, a fun way to exercise. Fitness centers, schools, parks, offices. Zumba sessions were held almost every corner of the barangays. The Philippine Sports Commission brought this mass Zumba dancing to many places as well, to the delight of women and girls from all walks of life.
We heal as one with kindness. We heal as one.
A major turn of event in 2020 has totally changed this landscape of mass dancing.
Community quarantine is hereby imposed in the entire of Metro Manila.
Ang mga kaso ng COVID-19 na naitala sa bansa.
Sa kabuuan, 771,497 na ang mga tinamaan ng sakit.
The COVID-19 pandemic has stopped the way we used to keep our fitness. After more than a year, this pandemic is taking a heavy toll on emotional and mental health. The unprecedented increase in the number of people who feel depressed and anxious must be addressed. At this point, the Philippine Sports Commission would like to encourage everyone to do solo exercise workout through dancing inside the homes. Because music, sound frequencies, and rhythm have therapeutic ability to treat physical and psychological issues brought about by the pandemic. With us today is the chairman of the Philippine Sports Commission, William I. Ramirez, to welcome everyone to this new world of solo dancing.
Good morning. For the first time in the Philippine sports, where we launch a dance exercise, workout music for all the girls, of course the boys, and to everyone during this pandemic. I look at it that the benefits of dancing, whether Zumba or ballet or hip-hop or whatever dance, it will help individual to stay fit, can improve their muscles, strength, endurance, and fitness. It's a way of meeting new great friends and will improve your heart and lungs, which is vital against pandemic. And lastly, the most important thing is to improve the quality of life. So I would like to congratulate Commissioner Celia Kiram and all the supporting staff for engaging into a very healthy quality of life exercises in the midst of pandemic. Mabuhay po kayo.
Thank you, Chairman, for your inspiring message. Meantime, the Philippine Sports Commission is proud to present to you the original dance exercise music, Igalaw Galaw Ating Katawan, sang and danced by the Ramos sisters, Jamela, Princess Jaka, and Jonna Olympia. Ladies and gentlemen, this is all for you. Let's all dance together.
makamit mo rin ang ninanais mo. Rise up and shape it up.
Your host for today's exciting episode featuring the most awaited final round of Season 2 of Zumbarangay Pilipinas Solo Exercise On-Camp Challenge. We are about to witness the top performers in an exclusive gala awards night held at the Subic Travelers Hotel. Hold on and relax as you watch a glimpse of important and fun-filled moments of the awards gala.
Now is the moment of truth, the most exciting judgment time. But before we start, the Philippine Sports Commission would like to thank all the beautiful women, girls, and LGBTQIA who sent their video performance entries for Season 2. We are sending all of you a certificate of appreciation for the wonderful efforts for Zumbarangay Pilipinas. Please continue exercising for your wellness, and most of all, in closing this Zumbarangay Pilipinas 2022, we have made open consciousness that dancing is fun and a therapeutic activity for all ages. We still have an hour to get inside the hall.
So while we still have an hour to get inside the hall, let's take this opportunity to interview one of our panel of judges, Coach Len Ruis. All right, good evening, Coach.
Good evening, Julia.
All right, so here's my question for you. What do you think makes this a final and awards gala night exciting?
Well, this gala night will be a very exciting moment for the new finalists, and you got to meet new friends, new faces, and discover new talents. So that's what makes it exciting.
All right, new faces and new talents. So, Coach, what advice can you give to our future winners or even our competition for tonight?
Well, first of all, I would like to congratulate everyone or every guest participant and finalist here tonight. And I would like to advise you to go on and on, that you have discovered this talent and continue to develop it, because this is the Lord's gift to us.
All right. Thank you so much, Coach Len, and I will see you later at our awards night gala.
See you later.
All right. For our next judge, let me interview for you guys our 2022 SEA Games Dance Sport Competition gold medalist in Hanoi, Vietnam, Miss Stephanie Sabalo. Hello, good evening, Miss Stephanie.
Good evening. Good
so
evening.
My question for you, Miss Steph, is what makes this gala night or this final awards gala night exciting?
For me, because it's a great avenue to discover another new talents, and at the same time, it's a great avenue for new possibilities for having a next project for it, you know. And it's a good celebration of talent.
Good celebration of talent. So, Ms. Steph, last na po, what advice or what will be your message to our winners or even our participants for tonight?
My advice to all our participants and for the winners also is that winning doesn't justify everything that you do. Just make sure that once you have took something and you cared and you're so passionate about it, make sure to give it your all and make sure to give it all your heart, and always remember that everything is possible with God. Just keep pursuing, just keep going, and just keep moving forward.
Just keep moving forward. All right, a very inspirational message. Thank you so much, Miss Steph, and I will see you later.
Thank you.
Okay. And last but not the least, we have our four-time National Volleyball Team member and our former PSC commissioner, Miss Tisha Abundo. Good evening, Miss Tisha.
Yes, good evening. Nice to be with you guys.
Oh, it's nice to be with you, Paul, Miss Tisha. Okay, so my question for you, Miss Tisha, is what do you think makes this final and awards gala night exciting?
It is very exciting. It's one of a kind. I mean, nobody does this but PSC.
Of course, Ms. Tisha. What message can you give to our participants and winners for tonight?
Yeah, I'm amazed. They're so really with jest and excitement, even rehearsing as early as 2 in the afternoon. I was really surprised. Very good.
So what do you think the advice you can give them, Ms. Tisha? What advice, from your personal experiences, what can you share with these young talents?
These young talents should also extend it to their future children and the family too. Me, even my maids, I trained them to toss the ball and serve.
Yes.
They should also extend their talent
to their families. All right. Yes. So thank you so much, Miss Tisha, and we will see you later at our gala night.
Yes, sure.
Naging masaya po ako. Tapos kalo ko manghihiya sa mga tao, pero hindi naman pala. Kaya ko pa po sa mga ibang Zumbarangay, pag sali po ulit ako, kaya ko pa po yun. Kasi mag-iipon ako ng trophy. Ayun po, thank you po sa inyo lahat. Love you, bye-bye. Ingat po kayo. Mag-hapon po kayo lagi at mag-pigit at mas. Bye-bye po, kasi po mag-COVID, mag-ingat.
Sa pagkapanalo ko po sa Zumbarangay, mas tumaas po ang aking self-confidence to challenge myself more. And natulungan din po ako not just financially, but also to unleash my fullest potential. It changed me a lot from being a mahihiyain girl to a more confident one.
I can recommend Zumbarangay for both exercises and mind-body fitness activity. Since whenever we move our body, we're not just doing exercise, but also we release stress in our minds, knowing that we were happy doing the steps and enjoying dancing with Zumbarangay music. It will really make our mind more relaxed and also be more physically fit for our daily activities.
Una po sa lahat, maraming po salamat sa PSC dahil sa ganitong dance contest nagkaroon po ako ng karanasan na ipakita sa mga tao ang kakayahan ko sa pagsasayaw. Maraming din po salamat sa friends, family, and coaches na isa rin pong dahilan kung ba't ako nagkaroon ng confidence at lakas na ipakita sa maraming tao ang kakayahan ko sa pagsasayaw. Po, dahil makakuha tayo dito ng lakas at low spots at maganda rin po ito sa ating katawan. Mahilig rin po ay pagsasayaw, na huwag po kayong matatakot, pag na huwag po kayong mahihiyan na ipakita sa maraming tao ang inyong kakayahan sa pagsasayaw. At ito rin po ay susi sa inyong kinabukasan. Po ni Martha Graham, Dance is the hidden language of the soul. Kaya huwag niyo po kayo tigil, kaya niyo po yan. Maraming pong salamat!
Malaki ang naging impact ng pagkapanalo ko sa Zumbarangay sapagkat mas lalo nito na pagtibay ang pagtitiwala ko sa aking kakayahan pagdating sa larangan ng pagsasayaw at tiwala sa sarili pati na rin sa pakikisama. Malaki at maraming benepisyo ang ating nakukuha sa pagdating ng pagsasayaw bilang isang ehersisyo sapagkat nakatutulong ito hindi lamang sa ating pangangatawan pati na rin sa ating isipan. At ngayong nasa pandemya nga tayo, mas lalo natin kinakailangan ito upang mapanatili ang kalusugan ng ating katawan at ng ating isipan.
Malaki po yung impact ng pagkapanalo ko sa Zumbarangay. Bukod sa pagpa-practice, which is nakatulong para mas maging fit yung katawan ko, para mas enhance yung skills ko sa pagsasayaw at para mas maging healthy yung body ko, kumilos ng fat. Nakatulong din po yung napanalunan ko para sa mga kailangan ko sa school, sa bahay, at mga pansariling pangangailangan ko po. Ang may papayo ko po sa iba na magsasayaw is keep dancing dahil kahit hindi ka po kagaling, kahit Zumba, which is madali, makakatulong ito sa pag loose ng mga fats. Makakatulong din ito para mas maging fit ka, para mas ma-enhance mo yung pagsasayaw mo, mas naging flexible, and para ma-relax din yung katawan mo and yung mind mo.
Simula nung nanalo ako sa Zumbarangay Pilipinas, mas tumaas pa yung confidence ko na humarap at mag-perform sa harap ng maraming tao. Sobrang laking tulong din ng pagkapanalo ko dahil sa prize na ibinigay sa aming top 3 dahil nabili ko yung mga bagay na kailangan ko. Ang pagsasayaw ay para na din pag-eersisyo di lang sa ating katawan, kundi pati na rin sa ating isip. Dahil buong katawan natin ay gumagalaw, pati ang ating isipan na gumagana dahil sa mga steps na kinakabisado at ginagawa natin habang tayo ay sumasayaw. Malaking tulong din ang pagsasayaw di lang sa ating katawan, kundi pati na rin sa ating mental health, dahil enjoy ito gawin at ang pag-eersisyo ay nakakatulong sa pag-improve ng ating mood.
Well, the impact of winning on Zumbarangay for me is to express more about my insecurities. Lagi kasi sa akin pag mataba ako, ang pangit ko sumayaw, ganun. Pero Zumbarangay taught me that if there's a chance that you can go all out and express yourself, go and grab it. So, and my answer to your second question is yes. Dancing is one of the exercise that I do. I dance K-pop and everything. Turns out that it helps you sweat and burn some fat. And it can make your katawan to be groovy too. Besides, dancing is an exercise that can leave a smile on your face when you execute it correctly and happily. Thank you.
Malaking impact po sa akin bukod po sa na-achieve ko manalo. Nakatulong po siya sa aking katawan. At lalo nagkaroon po ako ng health competence sa sarili ko. At pwede ko po siya maipara sa ibang tao na apakilisisyo, malaking bagay po para nakatulong sa ating kalusugan at lalo po sa ating mga puso. Maraming salamat po.
So para po sa akin, ang impact po ng pagkapanalo ko sa Zumbarangay ay na-boost po ang aking self-confidence. Kasi po sa totoo lang, hindi ko po in-expect na mapapabilang po ako sa top 3 at second place pa. So maraming salamat po sa inyong lahat. At para naman po sa akin, maipapayo ko pong exercise ang pagsasayaw. Kasi kapag nagsasayaw tayo, lahat po ng ating katawan ay gumagalaw. At syempre pati na rin ang ating mind, kasi mag-iisip tayo ng creative steps para po bumagay sa tugtog. So parang para sa akin, alternative na rin itong pagsasayaw sa workout. Kasi kapag sumasayaw po tayo, lalo na po ng Zumba, ay gumagalaw po ang ating buong katawan, pati na rin po ang ating isip. So yun lang po, thank you po.
Not at your best? You may be dehydrated. You need Pocari Sweat. It replaces the electrolytes you've lost and helps you perform at your best. Be at your best with Pocari Sweat. Pocari Sweat.
Ceremonies. We would like to inform you that this special event is being covered
by our production team, airing at Rise Up, Shave Up on YouTube and Facebook channels. Ayan. With us tonight is the woman behind Zumbarangay Pilipinas, our commissioner in charge of women in sports, Dr. Celia Hiram. And let's give her a big round of applause, please.
Good evening, everyone. It is an honor to be back to this dancing hall, this time with a new set of young girls, women, and LGBTQ that will continue to be our partner in promoting healthy, active lifestyle, capitalizing on the powers of music and movement. Let me start this beautiful, sparkling night with my heartfelt thanks to the women, more than 100 women of them, girls and LGBTQs, and to our equally groovy judges who excitedly joined our campaign to raise awareness that nothing can stop this nation from dancing as a form of exercise, even at the height of this global crisis. Thank you, Judge Deva Bamogato. Can you arrest Judge Deva? Please stand up. Andito ba siya? Wala. Si Judge Allena Ruis. Round of applause, please. And Judge Tisha Abundo, dating Commissioner ng Philippine Sports Commission. As the Philippine Sports Commission closes tonight the curtains of Zumbarangay Pilipinas Season 2, ang bilis ng araw. Pangalawang season na natin agad ito. And hopefully, mag-continue pa ito kahit wala na kami sa Philippine Sports Commission. Kasi alam niyo naman, continuous kami with the President until June 30 na lang kami. Pero we're hoping and praying na whoever will take my place as the Women Oversight Commissioner sa Philippine Sports Commission ay pagpatuloy itong pagaganda natin na siguruan. We are more than delighted to have created and continue to promote a new stage of consciousness that no amount of crisis in life or challenging situation can demean or lessen the physical and psychological power of women, girls, and LGBTQs to quickly rise and move forward. We have the capacity and innovative mind set to reshape sadness and miseries into brilliant, optimistic, and cheerful state. And we are passionate about something we do it for love. Ganyan ang mga kababaihan, ganyan ang mga LGBTQs, at ang ating mga dalagiting that makes us so special and unique. So cheers to the empowered women, girls, and LGBTQs who choose to be part of this milestone project. On behalf of the Philippine Sports Commission, Women in Sports, I ask you all to continue to campaign. We have started in making our country a nation of physically robust and psychologically resilient, but tough and empowered community of women, girls, and LGBTQs. May our dancing in the crisis tonight and sound frequencies to calm and relieve physical and psychological stress. I can't forget the line from an unknown author that goes like, if you hit a wall, climb over it, crawl under it, or dance on top of it. Sa ating buhay, hindi natin maiiwasan ang mga problema na dumarating araw-araw. Minsan, tayo'y nasasaktan, minsan, tayo'y nanghihina. It is like hitting the wall, and you either get injured or cry in pain. Some people climb over it, meaning they rise above their pains or difficulties. Others dance on top of it. I am sure we all want to dance on top of all the challenges in life. Isayaw natin ang ating mga pagsubok. We created Subarangay Pilipinas because we desire that all shall dance on top of the pandemic and whatever life crisis that comes. There is no reason to be sorry or stand still. We want everyone to be moving forward. Igalaw-galaw ang ating katawan. With that note, thank you again for choosing to be part of Subarangay Pilipinas. Let me symbolically now open the curtains of a more dynamic campaign to dance on top of all challenges. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the new stage of a healthy lifestyle. The show must go on. Mabuhay kayong lahat at magandang gabi po ulit. Gusto ko po ulit ibanggit ang isa pa nating judge na wala dito sa aking script, si Judge Steph Sabalo. Maraming pong salamat.
We will present an entertainment you will never forget. Ayan, please welcome once again our Zumbarangay Pilipinas Season 1 Grand Winners, Jason, Zane, and Zach.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Presenting our beautiful talent from the Philippines. So, sit back, relax, and enjoy our
And was the youngest Filipina to be part of the national volleyball team
and compete in the 1996 Asian Games. Philippine Presidential Awardee as the most outstanding female national volleyball player. Appointed as PSC Commissioner in 1998, she organized the Philippines' first Palarong Kababaihan or Women's Games. As part of the celebration of the International Day for Women in 2000, let us all welcome Ms. Tisha Abundo. And last but not the least, a celebrity and multi-medalist international dance sport athlete won 2 golds and 1 silver in 19 SEA Games, clinched the top 5 position, besting 150 couples from around the world who competed in the Adult A Amateur 5 Dance category of the German Open Championships in 2015. And recently, the 2022 SEA Games gold medalist in dance sport competition in Hanoi, Vietnam. Let us all welcome once again, Ms. Stephanie Salvador. Thank you so much, judges. And now that you meet our jurados for tonight, we will be watching the finalists who are not with us tonight for personal reasons. So here they are. So these contestants will present some of their talent virtually. So hope you enjoy, and good luck to our contestants.
Kalimutan ang mga problema.
magpuwas ka lang. Huwag isipin ang tao na kapaligid sa'yo. Magkakamit mo rin ang ninanais mo. Rise up and shape it.
Thank you. kuya. Ayan. Let's clap our hands. Okay, so for our next solo performance, let us all welcome Chanel Lu Castro.
Monday.
In the Girl Open category, let us all welcome Shanley Toledo.
Thank you.
We have Richard Romulo.
Glory to God! Ibo lahat dugot pawis.
Thank you. Princess Malina.
The score is 77.33.
So Princess Malina is not here with us, so she is included.
Virtual kanina.
Yes, virtual of combination.
So for the second place, we have Shamata Esgana.
Congratulations, Ms.
Shamata.
For the women only category presented by Commissioner. You are our third
Quincy is also not here with us tonight. Quincy is from the virtual competition. Yeah, so congratulations to you, Quincy. And now for our first place. He will be receiving 20,000 pesos worth of cash, gift bags, and trophy. Congratulations to you. You've garnered 84.73%. You total score 253. Congratulations, Jericho Buendia! Congratulations. I would like to thank all of you very much for participating. Diba? From the participants to the winners and of course to our respective guests tonight. Thank you so much, especially to the Philippine Sports Commission and of course to our highly energized women and girls and LGBTQ. It is very peaceful and beautiful event. Yeah. Thank you so much and have a wonderful night, everyone.
You have just watched the final rounds and awards gala of Season 2 of Zumbarangay Pilipinas Solo Exercise On Camp Challenge. Again, thank you all to participants and congratulations to all the winners. Time is up for this week's Rise Up Shave Up episode. And don't forget to subscribe our YouTube and follow us on Facebook. Thank you everyone for your support. Rise Up Shave Up is brought to you by the Philippine Sports Commission Women in Sports. Again, this is your host Julia and have a marvelous day, everyone. Rise up and